So let's go ahead and back things up a little bit. Before you can make money from probate properties, you've got to get an offer accepted, which means you have to talk to the personal representative on the phone, which means you have to have contacted them and gotten them to respond in the first place. Now, in order to contact them, you've got to do your research and make yourself a mailing list of people to contact by phone and by email if possible, or by direct mail. The first step is making that list from the information you have found about properties that are going through the probate process in your area. Where do you find that? Well, you can look for the newspaper announcements that the personal representative is required to make 3 times on 3 consecutive weeks, showing or announcing that a new property is available and is going through the probate process. Also, you can get the information from the probate clerk's website or the circuit court clerk's website in your county. And finding that is as easy as Googling the phrase, your county's name plus probate court or probate records or probate properties or probate index and so on. Worst case, you have to drive down to the courthouse in your county or city once a week and see what new properties are available. There's always people there who can show you, if you ask them how, to use the computers there in order to see and access those lists. Regardless of how you get the information, the next step is to compile the information you found into a spreadsheet. Here's what you'll need. First of all, the name of the estate that's being probated. This is usually the full name of the deceased person who was the property owner, but died without a will. In the next column, you'll want the personal representative of the estate. This is almost always given along with the announcement, as well as their mailing address so that you'll know how to contact them by mail. There's also going to be a probate case number that's given. Just copy and paste that number right into it. And the address of the property itself so that you can find out more information about it later on. Now, I would add other columns too, such as the date that you mailed each letter to the personal representative. So go ahead and put 4 to 7 columns right there. And then to know what mailer to send on what day, you just open your handy-dandy spreadsheet and see when each one is due and go ahead and mark it with a new color or something when it's been mailed out. I would make a column for any notes on additional information you find out. And also, when you get a call from the personal representative, or when you finally talk to them, there's other information you'll want to write down here as well that you get from them. Now, you could go ahead and contact every personal representative at this point, or you could do a little more research in order to narrow down and weed out the properties that you're not interested in, so you don't have to pay for the mailers or the postage or take the time to send mail regarding properties that you don't really want to buy. What kinds might you not want to buy? Well, you might not want to buy a one-bedroom house, for example. Those are very hard to resell. They're not in high demand. Or even a two-bedroom house. 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms are the easiest ones to sell, or more. Any lower than that, it's not impossible. I've sold 2-bedroom, 1-bathroom houses before. And 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom houses, of course. It's just a little bit more difficult. The geographical area is pretty important. If there's a part of your county where it's more rural, or homes are taking forever to sell, you're not interested in it, or it's counties that you're not interested in, or cities within the county, then go ahead and exclude those from your list. Same goes for square footage. If it's under 1,200 square feet, you might have a harder time selling it unless that's pretty normal in your area. You can get this information by going to your tax assessor's website, which I've always found just by Googling your county name or city name plus property records or tax assessor. And you'll find a site where it says you can do a property search by owner name or by parcel number or by the street address. The street address is the easiest way to do it, just in case the owner has multiple properties. But in most counties and cities in this day and age, you can search the name or the address of a property, and you can find the information like square footage, bedrooms, bathrooms, its location, which you can also use Google Maps to see precisely where it is or how far it is from the nearest city or from your house. And any more information about the property, I would not invest the time in looking into at this point. Why? Because you haven't even contacted the personal representative yet. They haven't gotten back to you. I would only wait until they have and you've spoken with them and you have sensed some kind of motivation first before you spend additional time going down to the courthouse or going to other websites to get more information and pulling the file. Some other websites that can help you in doing research from your own home would be publicrecordfinder.com, searchsystems.com, .net, and also brbpub.com. That's BRB as in be right back, PUB.com. Now, you have the personal representative's name and address, and that is all that you need in order to send them a letter or postcard in the mail. We found that sending letters in the mail to the personal representative is the best way of getting them on the phone and getting a response from them. It also doesn't take much time to print up and send out a bunch of letters, and then only invest any more time after that once you've gotten a response. Now, what you don't want to do is just send one letter and then wait for a response, and if nothing happens, go ahead and give up or say this doesn't work. The fact is, the more letters you send up to a point, the more likely it is that they're going to respond to one of them. So what we want you to do is send 4 different letters to the personal representative, and you want to give them some time to respond or time for the process to develop on its own before you send the next mailer out. Reason being is making money with probates is not a hurry up kind of game. I mean, the process can go on for months. You'll want to send the first letter the day you record the initial probate information, right away, because that's your first contact. But then don't send the second letter for 3 months after the first letter has been sent out. This process can stretch on for quite a while, so if you bug them a whole lot up front, there might be nothing they can do yet, and there's no point in contacting them so often. Now, on the other hand, they might see your letter once and say, hey, that looks good, but it's not quite time yet to sell this property. 3 months later, time and circumstances will have changed, hopefully, and they get your letter, and then that's a reminder in case they lost the previous one. You're still around. You still want to help. They'll be more likely to get back to you. The third letter, send that out the 5th month from when you sent the first letter. And then lastly, the 4th and final letter, send it out 7 months after the first letter was mailed. So the first one send right away, and then send one 3 months, 5 months, and 7 months later. So even if you add up the postage and the cost of the letter and the envelope, etc., they might be only 60 cents each, or like $2.40 total to send each one of these 4 letters in the mail. The best kind of envelope to use is just a regular white letter envelope, and go ahead and hand write the contact information on it. Always the personal representative's name and address, and also the return address if you can get away with it or if you have the time. Otherwise, go ahead and stamp or print that on. That's the cool thing about probate deals. There's not a whole lot of them every month, so you're not going to be doing hundreds of these. You can knock them out while watching TV some night in your spare time. Now, sometimes people put stamps on the letter that you can get at any trophy and hobby store that says, Attention Personal Representative, or something to get their attention. But for the most part, when you or I receive a letter with a handwritten name and address on it, you tend to open it up because it looks like a normal letter and not junk mail. Sometimes people will call you and say, please stop sending me letters, we've got it taken care of, etc. And if that's the case, that's awesome. Tell them thanks for their time, sorry to bother you, and remove them from your list, and then you don't have to spend any more money printing and sending mailers to them. What do you want these letters to say? Well, the first one is going to look like regular business letter with your name and contact information at the top, followed by the personal representative's. Go ahead and say, Dear Personal Representative, or name them by their first name and last name. I want to offer my condolences on the recent loss of your loved one, as this may be a difficult time for both you and your family. Tell them what your name is and that you provide services that might be of benefit to them. I understand you've been appointed personal representative of the estate, which can be a daunting task. Then tell them what you do. I buy real estate, both residential and commercial. I can pay all cash. I can close quickly. I'll buy it as is. I won't jerk you around. And you can also purchase other kinds of personal property, automobiles, furniture, jewelry, etc. Can you imagine how this would be of interest to them? I mean, even if I was having a yard sale, I would be more excited to have one guy come in and buy it all than to go ahead and announce it and put up the flyers and sit in front of my house all morning. So let them know what you can do, that they're under no obligation. They have nothing to lose by at least seeing what you're willing to pay. So go ahead and give you a call if you have any questions or want to discuss selling any of the property. It also helps to remind them that they don't have to wait the 8-month period in order to sell anything. That once the court has given their permission, in most cases, they can go ahead and do it then. The following letters are pretty similar to the first one. They just get progressively shorter, and they basically remind them of what you said the first time around. My condolences to you. If you're squaring things away and need to sell the property, I can help. Here's what I do. Pay cash. Close quickly. Buy as is. One person can solve all these problems for you, and this includes personal property. Now, something else that's very true about marketing is the more ways that you contact someone, the more likely it is that you're going to get a response from them. So I also strongly suggest calling the personal representative on the phone. Now, first, you're going to have to get their phone number in order to do that. Here's some websites where you can search by someone's name in order to find out what their phone number is. First is whitepages.com, also superpages.com, and then two more, peoplefinder.com and zabasearch.com. That last one is Z-A-B, as in boy, A, search.com. Go ahead and enter the personal representative's phone number into your spreadsheet, and then knock out as many calls as you can in an hour, and see how many you get on the phone or who give you a call back. I understand it can be kind of scary, but then again, you are there to help them out and give them something they need. So just tell them the facts. There's no sales pitch. Pretty much reiterate the same thing in your letter. I saw that you're the personal representative. I want to offer you my condolences and also offer some help, if you need it, in selling the real estate. You can say you know where it is at the address, and also any personal property. They're basically either going to be interested or they're not. If they are, you find out more information and make an offer. Now, there's more on that later. And if not, then it's the same as if you offer someone a stick of gum and they say no. Do you take it personally? Is it a huge deal? No. You just find out, oh, okay, I don't need to contact them anymore. Or worst case, if they say we're working on it, you say, okay, fine, you don't have to call them anymore, but you can still send them mail because it's just a dollar or two more to send them the rest of the mailers. But you'll find that if you call people in addition to sending them mail, you will get more of them to call you back and or eventually get on the phone with you. You can also tell them I'm the guy that's sending you mailers, and just solidifies your credibility so when the time does come for them to respond, you're going to be the guy they call, just in case anyone else is sending them mailers. And I guarantee you that even if someone else is, and you have probate deal competitors, which, by the way, there's not a whole lot of them because they get looked over quite a bit. Other people are out chasing foreclosures, bankruptcies, etc. Few people are going to call them on the phone, and that's a fast and direct way to get them on the line and also set yourself apart. Now, if you get the personal representative on the phone, make sure to get their email address because that's going to be the easiest way to get a hold of them in the future. Email addresses before you've spoken with them, that's a little harder to find. It's not public information, and I wouldn't really trust any that you do find. Plus, it could be considered spam. So basically, you get information on the properties, send them four mailers over the course of 7 months, and give them a call on the phone. If you call once and leave a message, just state briefly what it's all about, and then try them again either a week or two later or the same time that you send the letter, 3 months, 5 months, 7 months later. Personally, I would try making a call once per week the first month because you want to get them on the phone right away to at least start that relationship with them so that when the time does come to sell, you're already the guy who's helping them out.